The cryptographic algorithms comprises of these two fields. Must. The definition is an absolute requirement of the specification, and implementation must include this feature or function to be in conformance with the specification. And the should field. There may exist a valid reason in particular circumstances to ignore this feature or function, but it is recommended that an implementation include the feature or function. Here are the rules and sequence to be followed by the sending agent. If the sending agent has a list of preferred decrypting capabilities from an intended recipient, it should choose the first, which is highest preference capability on the list that it is capable of using. If the sending agent has no such list of capabilities from an intended recipient, but has received one or more messages from the recipient, then the outgoing message should use the same encryption algorithm as was used on the last signed and encrypted message received from that intended recipient. If the sending agent has no knowledge about the decryption capabilities of the intended recipient and is willing to risk that the recipient may not be able to decrypt the message, then sending agent should use triple this. If the sending agent has no knowledge about the decryption capability of the intended recipient and is not willing to risk the recipient may not be able to decrypt the message, then the sending agent must use RC2/40. The SMIME makes use of a number of new MIME content types, which are as shown in the table. All of the new application types use of The destination PKCS. This refers to a set of public key cryptography specifications used by RSA laboratories and made available for the SMIME effort. Procedure for SMIME message preparation. These are the four general procedures. First one, securing a MIME entity. Second one, envelope data. Third one, signed data. Followed by the fourth one, clear signing. Securing a MIME entity. SMIME secures a MIME entity with a signature, encryption, or both. A MIME entity may be an entire message except for the RFC 5322 headers, or if the MIME content type is multipart, then a MIME entity is one or more of the subparts of the message. The MIME entity is prepared according to the normal rules for MIME message preparation. Then the MIME entity plus some security related data such as algorithm identifiers and certificates are processed by SMIME to produce what is known as a PKCS object. A PKCS object is then treated as message content and wrapped in MIME, provided with appropriate MIME headers. This process should become clear as we look at specific objects and provide examples. In all cases, the message to be sent is converted to canonical form. In particular, for a given type and subtype, the appropriate canonical form is used for the message content. For a multipart message, the appropriate canonical form is used for each subpart. The use of transfer encoding requires special attention. For most cases, the result of applying the security algorithm will be to produce an object that is partially or totally represented in arbitrary binary data. This will then be wrapped in an outer MIME message, and transfer encoding can be applied at that point, typically base 64. However, in the case of a multi-part signed message, described in more detail later, the message content in one of the subparts is unchanged by the security process. Unless that the content is 7-bit, it should be transfer encoded using base 64 or coated printable so that there is no danger of altering the content to which the signature was applied. The envelope data, an application PKCS 7 MIME subtype, is used for one of four categories of SMIME processing, each with a unique SMIME type parameter. In all cases, the resulting entity, referred to as the one in the object, is represented in a form known as Basic Encoding Rules, BER, which is defined in ITU-T recommendation X.209. The BER format consists of arbitrary octet strings and is therefore binary data. Such an object should be transfer encoded with base 64 in the outer MIME message. We first look at the envelope data. The steps for preparing an envelope MIME entity are as follows. Generate the pseudo-random session key for a particular symmetric encryption algorithm, RC2/40, or triple dash. Second one being, for each recipient, encrypt the session key with the recipient's public RSA key. Third one, for each recipient, prepare a block known as recept info that contains a identifier of the recipient's public key certificate, an identifier of the algorithm used to encrypt the session key, and the encrypted session key. The last point being, encrypt the message content with the session key. The recipient info blocks followed by the encrypted content constitute the envelope data. This information is then encoded into base 64. To recover the encrypted message, The recipient first writes off the base64 encoding. Then the recipient's private key is used to recover the session key. Finally, the message content is decrypted with the session key. The signed data SMIME type can be used with one or more signers. For clarity, we confine our description to the case of a single digital signature. The steps for preparing a signed data MIME entity are: select a message digest algorithm. It can be SHA or MD5. Second one, compute the message digest, that is the hash function of the content to be signed, followed by encrypt the message digest with the signer's private key, followed by prepare a block known as signer info that contains the signer public key certificate, an identifier of the message digest algorithm, an identifier of the algorithm to use for encryption of the message digest, and encrypted message digest. The signed data entity consists of a series of blocks, including a message digest algorithm identifier, the message being signed, and signer info. The signed data entity may also include a set of public key certificates sufficient to constitute a chain from a recognized root or top level certification authority to the signer. This information is then encoded into base64. To cover the signed message and verify the signature, the recipient first types off the base64 encoding. Then the signer's public key is used to decrypt the message digest. The recipient independently computes the message digest and compares it with the decrypted message digest to just verify the signature. If the signature matches, then it is a valid message.